Hi guys, back down in the shop tonight for another repair video. Now this is something that's not too common for most of you guys, something I come across quite a bit in my line of work. This is a directional control valve for a piece of equipment, and there's all different brands, different styles. This is, I think, a single crossover type. Now this valve here, this is a kind of an odd scenario where we have some debris caught inside the solenoid and it's stuck in one direction. So I'll take the camera down and I'll shine a light in there and we'll see what's stuck in there. But I figured I'd make a little video when I clean this up and take it apart, clean out what's stuck in there. And if any of you guys come across something similar to this, you'll have an idea of how to do it. This one is actuated by these two solenoid coils. So I'm also going to test those two. I know these are good, but I'll just show you the process of testing them as well. So I'm gonna take that apart now. Okay, first to test the coils, we're just gonna grab our multimeter and throw it on resistance. These I know are in the 200 range. You can get them that are, depending on the brand, much higher, but these between 0 and 200. So we'll clip those on and have a look. And I'm just going to clip it on the two outside terminals, as I know those are the ones that are used on this. So we can see here we got about 18 ohms, which I know is good for this particular coil. Like I said, different brands have different resistance. These are 24 volts. So here we got another 18 ohms. So I know those two are good, but that's a way that you can test them if you have your own that you're not sure of. So now I'm just gonna take these off so that I can disassemble the coil or the valve. So these just unscrew, slide off the end. Sometimes there's a little O-ring in between the plastic cover. All right. So now I'm just gonna take the camera down and we'll take a look inside there, and you can see the debris that's stuck in there. Okay, so now we're just gonna look right down there. And at this angle, you can see something orange. I'm just gonna try to focus on it if I can. But there's definitely some orange stuff in there. And this is actually the third time this has happened on this piece of equipment. And it's orange plastic, and we're not sure where it's coming from. But I just keep cleaning it out, and eventually I'm hoping it'll run out and we'll find the source. So I'm going to disassemble that now, and we'll clean that out. Now these can be on there quite tight, so I'm just gonna throw it in the vise and loosen it up first. And then we can take the rest off over there. Okay, now to complete the disassembly, we're just going to unscrew this end. You can see here we've got a little spring and an O-ring. And just inside of here, whatever this type of washer thing is. Now just note the orientation of how that goes. This one here, the spring fits in there. I'll do the other side. Now in this particular valve, these are the same, so it doesn't matter if I mix them up, but that may not be true for all valves. So I've got those two pieces out. Now here's the center piece. I don't know what it's called, but there's the piece of plastic that we're looking for. So that's out of there. I'm just going to grab a pick and a light and we'll see if there's not more hidden in there. Okay, just gonna have a little peek in there. Not sure we got it all. that's the second piece. I believe that's it, so I'm going to put that back together now. Okay, so now I'm going to reassemble it. Now, like I said, this valve is the same in both directions, but not all of them will be. So in this case, it doesn't matter what direction I put that in, but be sure you check the valve you're working on to make sure it's symmetrical. So first I'm going to put that in, that center piece. Then I'm going to put this little guy in here. And there's two little channels inside of there, two tabs on this washer. So I'm going to line those up. I'm going to center that on the washer. And put this guy at the top. Let's put that in. Over and do the same thing again. Let me give that a quick tighten on the vise. Now ready to put those coils back on. Just put this one on here. I only have one O-ring, I'm not sure why, so I'm going to go on one side. Tighten that up. And one more. There. That's it for that. Now I've got these. Piece of plastic, so you could have all kinds of stuff in there, just dirt that got into your oil and it got past the filter, broken hose. Well, this is something you can do to try to service that. Now, I mentioned that these were 24 volt coils, but they will actually run at 12 volts. So if you see here, I've got our trusty power supply. So I'm going to turn that on and we'll actually activate the coils to see if they work. So I'm just going to turn that on now. And I'll put the positive on one of these posts. I'll grab the negative here. I'm just going to set the camera up so you guys can see that little shaft inside. Now as I power that coil, you can see that valve move. Yeah, we'll try the other one. Perfect. Well, this was just a quick repair video. If you're new to my channel, I like to do types of repairs and projects, hobbies, all kinds of stuff. So once in a while, I'll throw in one of these boring repair videos for those of you like me who need to fix things, and it's helpful to find a YouTube video on how to do it. If you guys enjoyed this video, hit the thumbs up button. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do, and I'll see you in the next one.